So we're going to start our problem with a regular hexagon with the side of 2. Then we're going to mark the centers of 5 sides of this hexagon. Then we're going to start pulling some lines. First, we're going to pull the line from the bottom right corner of the hexagon to the upper right midpoint. And we're going to pull another line from the bottom midpoint to the upper right midpoint, as you can see on the sketch. Then we will pull the line through the center of the hexagon and another line from bottom left corner to the upper midpoint of the hexagon. And finally, we're going to pull the line from this same corner to the upper left midpoint, and we're going to connect 2 midpoints on the left, and in this way we will form these 3 triangles. The question is, can we somehow calculate the combined area of those 3 triangles? This question was actually presented to me by one of my subscribers from Japan, Akio. Akio wanted me to solve, and I quote him, the area of the claws inside the hexagon. And for me to call this problem a claws, I found it really, really intuitive. So thanks again, Akio, for this wonderful suggestion. So you can pause this video right now, tackle this problem, and then come back and check the solution. All right, so let's solve this one. So, I'm going to show you 2 different methods to solve this problem. In the first method, we're going to think the way to simplify our hexagon. So, first we're going to lose those shapes for a moment, and then we're going to think how to simplify this hexagon. If we connect 3 opposite points of a regular hexagon, we will form an equilateral triangle. We can do the same by connecting the other 3 midpoints. And since this is the regular hexagon, those 2 triangles will actually be congruent. Next, we will pull all 3 big diagonals of the hexagon, and therefore, as you can see, we have divided our hexagon into 24 equilateral triangles. Now, let's focus on 1 equilateral triangle. If we label the side of this triangle as S and its height as H, we actually know that the height of the equilateral triangle is equal to the side times square root of 3 over 2. So we're going to use this fact later. But first, let's reintroduce our shapes. Alright, so let's first start with the shape number 1. As you can see, this is a triangle, and you can notice that the base of this triangle is actually the base of our equilateral triangle, so we can label it as S. And the height of this triangle is actually equal to the 3 times the height of 1 small equilateral triangle. So now we can easily calculate the area of this triangle as base times height over 2. So in our case, this will be S times 3H over 2. Next, let's have a look at our middle triangle. This triangle also has the base, which is equal to the base of the equilateral triangle, so we will label it as S. And the height of this triangle will be equal to 4 times the height of 1 equilateral triangle. So we can calculate its area as S times 4H over 2. And finally, let's have a look at the triangle on the left. In order to understand this a little bit better, we will first rotate our image a little bit. Then you can see that the base of this triangle is also equal to the side of the small equilateral triangle S, and the height of this triangle will be equal to the height of the equilateral triangle, which we can label as H. Then, from this, we can get that the area of this red triangle must be equal to the S times H over 2. Alright, so now let's rotate our image back. And let's try to work with our values. So we can get the area of those claws as the sum of the areas of those 3 triangles. So we can just substitute our values in and we will get the following. Now we can simplify this a little bit by isolate the common factor of s over 2 and then simplify more to get that this is equal to s over 2 times 8h. Now we can cancel 8 and 2 and finally get that our red area must be equal to 4 times s times h. Alright, so now if you take a look at the side of our small equilateral triangle, you can see that this side is equal to the half of the side of our hexagon, so it must be equal to 1. Then we will just substitute this value into our formula for the height, which we got earlier, and we can calculate this to get that the height of this triangle is equal to square root of 3 over 2. Now we will just substitute the values of s and h into our formula and we will get the following. After simplification, we will get that our wanted red area is equal to 2 square root of 3 squared units, and this is our solution. Alright, so now let me show you the second method, which I called an origami method to pay homage to the Japan. And this one is actually quite fun. So first, we're going to start the same way as we did before, and we're going to divide our regular hexagon into 24 identical equilateral triangles. Then we will pull back our red shapes. And I call this method an origami, since this image really greatly reminds me of folded origami paper. Now we're going to play with those shapes a little bit. First, let's take a look at the triangle on the right. We can cut the top of this triangle and rearrange it a little bit. Then we will do the same with this small piece. Now let's have a look at the triangle in the middle, and let's do some more cutting. So we're going to cut the paper here and rearrange it, then we will cut this part in the middle, then we will cut the top of the triangle and place it here, and we will slide this small side on the bottom upward, and finally we will cut this small piece and put it here. Next, let's have a look at the triangle on the left. We're going to do the same thing. We're going to slide its bottom piece upward, then we will cut the top, rotate it and slide it here, and finally we will rotate this small piece and place it here. In this way we have played around with the shapes, but as you can see we got 8 equilateral triangles which we made from those 3 triangles. So now let's first find the area of the hexagon as 6 times the side of the hexagon squared times square root of 3 over 4. This is the standard formula for the area of the regular hexagon, since the regular hexagon is made out of 6 equilateral triangles. So now we will just substitute the side of our hexagon. We will work through this and simplify to get that the area of the hexagon is 6 square root of 3. Now, if you take a look at the sketch again, you can see that our red area is made out of 8 equilateral triangles. But since the whole hexagon contains 24 of those triangles, this means that our red area must be equal to the 8 over 24 of the area of the hexagon. So we can simplify this 8 over 24 to get that our red area is actually equal to 1/3 of the area of our hexagon. Now we will just substitute the value for the area of the hexagon and simplify this, and finally we will get that our wanted red area must be equal to 2 square root of 3 squared units, and again we have our solution. Alright, so I really hope that you enjoyed this interesting problem, and if you did, please do not hesitate to leave a like or subscribe to the channel, those stuff really means a lot. Of course, if you found another way to solve this problem, please write it down in the comment section as you always do. And until next time, see you all and take care.